Taslima, hi. Yeah, I'm able to see you. One sec. If you can see, please do accept it. Waiting for Taslima Sheikh to join. Hi, Taslima.
Hello, Sharon. Good afternoon. Sorry, good morning.
Good morning.
One second.
Give me a minute. One second. Yeah, Taslima, hi, how are you?
I am fine, how are you?
I am doing good. So before we start our question and session, please introduce us about your hotel. Apart from butterflying, what do you do, what's your profession?
I am doing research in butterflies. I am doing PhD from Jammu and Kashmir. I am working on butterflies.
Okay, so we will get started. How did it all start? When did you start butterflying? In which year?
This is my hobby, and I started this from 2016. I started working from 2016 actually, and after that I came in PhD in 2018.
Okay. Why yeah. Butterflies in specific?
What?
Why butterflies in specific?
Actually, I am interested in butterflies because these creatures are easily approachable, and in entomological field, their identification is easy, and these can be reared at home as well. So I chose.
Okay. Do you remember the first butterfly you ever sighted once you came into this hobby?
Plain tiger butterfly.
Okay. Tell me about your inspirations in this field of butterfly.
There are so many people which are working as an inspirational model. First of all, I would like to tell that you are also an inspiration because you are from non-biology background. I have seen your profile, and you are from, I think, computer engineering background. So you have so much knowledge about these butterflies, and I would like to call two names. One is Subhajit Roy, from West Bengal, and another is Aniruddha. These both are working in butterflies as their hobby. They are exploring these creatures, and they have done so much in this field. Being from non-biologist background, Subhajit is from, I think, BCom, and Aniruddha is from engineering background. They are the most inspirational people for me. If they are doing well, I can also do well, being a zoology student. And one more name I would like to call here, that is butterfly man of Pakistan, that is Akram Awan, who inspired me a lot, because he is also a non-biology student.
I never knew Akram was a non-biology student. I thought he had a biology background.
No. He is also from engineering background.
Okay. The next question is, what needs to be done to make this field more accessible for women? And also, the second part of this question is, did you face any challenges when you took up butterflies? Being in Jammu and Kashmir,
you
would have a lot to stand.
Yes. Yes, as being a girl, being a lady, it is not accessible to move to the longer places, to the higher places like mountains, hills, to approach these butterflies. But somehow we can walk into the gardens, which are nearly possible places. I have explored much of the Jammu and Kashmir areas, and I can say that I have collected. And I have killed butterflies also. This is not good for butterfly lovers, I know. I have killed for the museum collection, that we have to do this for science. And I have collected 250 species so far. and those butterfly which are not which are mentioned in the IUCN endangered list or wildlife protection act, I have not collected those one, but I have collected all the commoners which were easily approachable. And the thing which what makes us to make this as more accessible to this in this field, as you said, like we can create butterfly gardens in our home, we can plant more and more trees, larval host plants in our home which are easily approachable, and in this way we can do butterflying at home also. But in Jammu and Kashmir, I think it is not so much possible for me as well, that I can move to the further places, like you know, as there are many issues also.
How safe it is to butterfly around in Jammu and Kashmir?
Actually, being a research scholar, I can say I have been in many places for butterflying, but not alone. I was with my supervisor, as I am working under the supervision of Dr. who taught me about all the stretchings on the insect, like insect stretching boards, who was with me in the field time. And it was not accessible for me to go inside the field alone. And many of my lab mates, many of my friends who joined me at that time, at the time that was possible.
Okay,
but alone I was not able to manage.
Okay. Do you have any tips for bringing children to like and study butterflies?
Yeah, we can make small pamphlets, we can make handbooks. As in 2018 I compiled a booklet on Jammu butterflies. I would like to show picture of that booklet here. I have compiled this, and this is my local first local publication. And this book comprises 90 species from the Jammu region, and this was published by DEERS Department, Department of Ecology, Environment, and Remote Sensing Department. So, this book helped a lot. And I have distributed this book in schools, colleges also. I think handbook is easily picked up by students, which can make interest in them.
Yeah. Also, tell me more about your work on butterflies, like PhD you are doing.
Okay. Actually, like if we call that first reporting, like many authors has left unattended many butterflies, unseen many species in Jammu and Kashmir. Like I'm representing Jammu and Kashmir this time, as Ladakh has been separated from Jammu and Kashmir. Ladakh has different flora and fauna, so I would like to talk about Jammu and Kashmir. Both parts are different in their flora and fauna. Even Kashmir is temperate in region, temperate in climate, and Jammu is somewhat hotter, tropical and deciduous type of climate. And as I have reported around 26 new butterfly reportings which were first seen by me. I would like to call some names here which are published in records of Zoological Survey of India, like common onyx, baronet, medusa process, that is commander, black raja, plains blue royal, and many more others. Like large oak blue. And I would like to tell that like adjacent places like Punjab, Pakistan and Himachal Pradesh, these are the countries and states which are helping me a lot. Like these adjacent areas can tell me that in future likely which butterfly can be seen in my Jammu and Kashmir. Like many butterflies are seen in adjacent Pakistan, like titlers, multi-spotted common flat, like many others butterflies are seen in Punjab Punjab also, like common small flat is seen in Punjab, but in future I can see in this butterfly in Jammu and Kashmir as well. And these states and countries are helping me a lot, as Akram Awan is connected with me since 2012 in this field, and he is helping me. He's teaching me all the basics of butterflies. He's showing me the keys, local keys he has made for the Butterfly Book of Pakistan. He is telling me about the features of Himalayan butterflies and all.
Okay. Can you tell me who is your favorite butterfly partner?
Yes, there are so many butterflies which are favorite in my list. Like I would like to call a few names here. Tortoise butterfly shell, which is Aglaeus Kashmirensis, which is commonly found in northeastern part, Namcha Parvat to Nanga Parvat range.
Yeah.
And one more butterfly is common yellow swallowtail.
One second. I asked you who is your favorite butterfly partner. Butterfly buddy, you go around in the field.
Okay. Actually, I told you I'm working in PhD, and I usually go with my supervisor. Actually, I don't have any butterfly partner, but still I used to go with my parents, my siblings and all.
Okay. The next question is, do you remember how many butterflies you have seen till date?
Yes, I can say both pictorial on social media around 400 species, and live in my Jammu and Kashmir I have collected, as I told you, I have collected 250 butterfly species, and in our checklist around 300 butterflies are here, and on social media as well as live butterflies I have seen around 400.
Nice. So Jammu has currently 300 species of butterfly.
What are you saying? It's not audible.
No. What's the count on Jammu and Kashmir butterflies? You said 250 to 300.
Excluding Ladakh. Okay. Excluding Ladakh, we have around 300 butterflies here. Excluding Ladakh.
Okay. Are there any rare butterflies you have encountered or rare in Jammu and Kashmir?
Voice is not audible.
Can you hear me now?
Yeah, then.
No, I was asking, is there any rare butterfly or endemic butterfly to Jammu and Kashmir which you have encountered or which you have not about?
Still, your voice not audible.
Can you hear me now?
Yeah, tell.
I was asking about, are there any endemic butterfly or rare butterfly in Jammu and Kashmir or which you have heard or learned about?
Actually, we cannot say endemic, but we can say we have so many species rare which are found in only some areas only, like Himalayan regions like Uttarakhand, Himachal and Jammu and Kashmir, in some parts of Jammu and Kashmir, like Kashmir White, that is Pyrus deota, and many other like old world swallowtail, yellow swallowtail, Papilio meconi is found here, which is not seen everywhere, which is not seen in every part of the India, but only seen in Jammu and Kashmir or some parts of Himalaya. These are not endemic, but these are seen in rare parts of India.
Okay. Can you tell me your dream destination for India?
I'm not listening. Please repeat.
Can you tell me your dream destination for butterflying in India?
For India, I have not thought so much. But for J&K aspect, I would like to compile a book. And I would like to compile many other things, like in the Mures time, 1985, we can say 1838, Moore's time, I would like to see those beautiful butterflies again after so many years. I would like to explore all the beauties. I would like to conserve the habitat. I would like to conserve the rare plants which are found in Himalayas only. Like there are so many plants which are facing threats due to the habitat destruction, due to the grazing of cattle in the fields. As in our Himalaya, many lichens are bottom flies and they are used to feed on the local wild plants, and these wild plants are being grazed by the cattle. I will love to conserve these wild plants here.
Okay, I guess that was my next question. I was about to ask what next step you would plan to take on contribution to the butterfly society.
I would like to conserve, as I told you, I would like to conserve wild plants. I would like to construct a butterfly garden in Jammu and Kashmir, as we don't have any butterfly garden in here. And I would like to recommend a Union Territory butterfly, as many contributions I can do in the form of booklets, pamphlets. I can make awareness in any form.
Okay. I guess I have come to the end of my questions and suggestion. I think we'll wait for the viewers. If they have any questions, you can answer them. Viewers, if you have any questions to Taslima, you can ask her questions. She's from Jammu and Kashmir. And I saw Neha something. When you showed the booklet, Neha said, "Nice booklet, Taslima. Can we have a soft copy?"
Yeah, you have to come to Jammu and Kashmir because this is local publication.
No, we have
after lockdown. After lockdown, I'll send a copy of that. Send me your address.
You're talking about hard copy. Do you have a soft copy of the book?
Yeah, I have soft copy also in my laptop. I'll share.
Okay, sure. Yes. We'll see if there are any more questions. Sohail from Delhi is asked, are you conducting any education programs currently, butterfly education programs?
Actually, I'm working on butterflies. I'm not conducting any program, but I'm working on it.
Okay.
Someone has written, do caterpillar have teeth?
He's just playing around. The next question is
it's
by
great that
yeah you can read.
If you have to vote, what will be your butterfly of J&K? I'll suggest common yellow swallowtail, that is Papilium acorn.
Ashwati is asking you, it is great that you are researching in butterflies. Can you mention what aspects you focus on?
Their conservation.
Okay.
Aniruddha, I'll send you one copy.
Okay. Priyanka from Bombay, she's asking, so when farmers are threatened with some of species, how do we contribute to bridge the gap in destruction by some butterflies?
With the inclusion of government, we can do.
And one more question. You said some butterflies only occur in Jammu and Kashmir. You make effort to make it a state butterfly.
I'm not getting.
He's asking.
You said, you said some butterflies only occur in Jammu and Kashmir. You make efforts to make it as a state butterfly. Okay, I'll make.
We are from West Bengal, she's saying, don't forget me, Taslima, I want one copy too.
Okay, I'll give you one copy. Here is your copy.
Any more questions for Taslima related to her work on butterflies of Jammu and Kashmir? We'll wait for a couple more minutes and we'll see if there are any more questions. Before we end this live, thank you so much, Taslima. Thank you for accepting me and my request to join this
Thanks, Sharon, for giving me this opportunity.
Lot of people are asking a soft copy of your book.
Varsha, I want one copy too. I'll give you all.
I guess we don't have any other questions. So people, if you have any questions or concerns regarding Butterface of Jammu and Kashmir, please feel free to text Taslima either in Facebook or Instagram. I'll be happy to answer you all. And yeah, I think we have come to the end of the session. Thank you so much, Taslima. Thank you again. Thanks for being a part of this event.
Thank you, Sharan.
It was nice meeting you. Looking forward to meeting you in person sometime.
Okay. Bye-bye.
Bye.